Megan here from MeganMins.com, and today I'm gonna share with you my 5 favorite productivity apps for your phone. I use these apps every single day, and they've made a huge difference in how focused and productive I am throughout the day, so I'm really excited to share them with you. The first app that I'm gonna share with you is called Brainfm, and it is a music app. Now, I've always loved listening to music when I work. I used to go to Spotify and listen to some of their more focused playlists, but after a while it would get repetitive, or maybe the songs would distract me, which kind of defeats the whole purpose. Once I tried Brainfm, I was blown away by what a difference I saw. Brainfm allows you to choose between 5 mental states: focus, meditate, sleep, nap, and relax. And you can also select specific types of sessions as well, like beach, chimes, electronic, rain, anything like that. I always click the focus and I listen to that when I'm working. I also find that by listening to this focus playlist, I am getting out of my head and I stop overanalyzing. I have a really bad habit of just thinking a little bit too long about decisions before taking action on them, and it can really hang me up. But I find that if I have focused listening, for some reason, it just really allows me to stay focused. And if you wanna try Brainfm, they actually have a free version where you can listen to 7 sessions for free. And I actually bought the lifetime membership because I listened to it so much. So I paid one time and don't have to pay monthly for it ever again. But if you do wanna pay for it, the monthly plans start at $3.99. The next app is called Focus Keeper, which is a timer based on the Pomodoro technique. Now, I love working in Pomodoros, and if you don't know what that is, it's 25 minutes of focused work followed by a short 5-minute break afterwards. Now, I have shared before that I usually use a physical timer to track my Pomodoro sessions, and that's worked great for me, but I was actually recommended Focus Keeper recently by a friend. I have fallen in love with it and have started using it instead of my physical timer. Some of the key features that I love about Focus Timer are the flexible settings. You can adjust how long your Pomodoro sessions are, how many breaks you want to take, and so much more to really make this technique work for you. I also love how visually pleasing the timer is. It's always nice to have something that's pretty to look at. And I love that you can set goals for the number of Pomodoros you complete each day. Now, I have a set number of Pomodoros that in an ideal day I would complete, so I love that I can put this number in and customize it to my ideal day so that I can see how I'm doing and if I'm actually measuring up to what I think I should be doing every day. If you're interested in using Focus Keeper, there's a free version, which is actually the only version I have and use, but there is a $1.99 upgrade in case you want a few more pro features. I think most of it is just custom alarm sounds and more data tracking. So that's up to you. I am perfectly happy with the free version, but it's nice that if you do want to upgrade, it's less than $2. The third app I want to share with you is called Productive. Kind of perfect for this video, right? I actually love using Productive because it's really a habit tracker. When I'm trying to implement several new habits at a time, I love using Productive to help keep them top of mind and help build up my progress. Productive makes it really easy to add new habits to the system. There are tons of settings for each habit, especially recurring habits like daily, weekly, monthly. You can have it happen on specific days, a time of day, a specific time of day, or multiple times of the day. Plus, there's a huge database of habits that will help jumpstart you and give you ideas for habits you may want to implement. And you can even do fun little color-coded icons to just help make everything even more visually pleasing. If you're interested in using Productive, there is a free version. I actually upgraded to the paid version for $3.99, and it has been completely worth every penny, but definitely start with the free version first and see how you like it. The fourth app is Asana, which I use to manage all of my tasks and projects. When I'm on my laptop, I usually use the web version of Asana, but I love that no matter where I am, I always have it on my phone. I use the iPhone app to check what's on my plate today, ask any questions I have, check the status on projects no matter where I am, and it's so nice to feel like I'm still in the loop no matter what my circumstance is. It's so easy to search, add projects or tasks, and jump between different workspaces. Plus, Asana syncs across all of my devices and the web instantly, so there's no delay in collaborating with my team. Even better, Asana is completely free, so definitely give it a shot. The fifth app is Google Drive, which is where I store all of my personal and business files. Being able to access, view, upload, and edit documents while on the go is amazing. It's probably the app that I open up most often throughout the day. I love that I can create any kind of document no matter where I am. And if I have an idea, I can just make a note right inside the Google Doc and it'll sync everywhere. The Google Drive app is completely free, so you can just download it and start using it right away. Now you know my top five productivity apps. But if you truly want to be more productive, you need to know how to plan out your day in advance. So be sure to watch my Plan Your Day video if you haven't yet. You can do that by clicking somewhere over here or in the link below this video. I've also got a free Plan Your Day workbook that accompanies that video that I'll also put in the link below this video so you can grab that too. I'd love to hear from you. What are some of your favorite productivity apps? Leave them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit that like button below so I know to make more videos just like this. I'll see you in the next one.
Am I recording?
Yes. Okay. Day plan. I hate this section. I'm gonna start over. And how you like to work. I suck. Maybe I should have champagne. Nah. I'll wait.